What's going on, everybody? Spunky991 coming, you guys, with another video. Sorry I haven't been uploading that much the past couple days. I've been very, very busy. I try to keep one or two videos uploaded each day. But sometimes, you know, this busy career or trucking, man. Sometimes just a busy day, man. You know, it takes up so much of your time. But I may not be uploading in the next couple days, for like the next two days, whatever. I may not be uploading as well because I'm headed to Canada. And, you know, my internet service in Canada is pretty bad. You know, it's pretty slow overall. So I tend to avoid, you know, uploading videos because, you know, up there in Canada, it takes me about two, three days to upload a short video up there. So I say screw it. I wait till I get back to the U.S. But anyway, man, coming at you guys with another video. Eagles head coach Doug Peterson spoke about the Eagles second string quarterback Nate Sudfeld. He spoke about his faith in Nate Sudfeld, confidence that Nate Sudfeld, you know, if God forbid, you know, knock on wood, but if Nate Sudfeld will have to come in if something happened to Carson Wentz. He spoke about coaching up Nate Sudfeld, about, you know, doing his job and coaching them up and letting the chip fall wherever they may at. He kept it very short, very simple during his press conference when talking about Nate Sudfeld. I'm going to read to you guys what Doug Peterson had to say in regards to Sudfeld. And of course, I gave my thoughts. So with that said, let me go ahead and get started. Like I said, very short, simple message by Pederson. He said that we were blessed to have Nick Foles. I've always been comfortable with Nate to take a hold of that backup spot, see his growth and his potential moving forward. As a coach, all I can do is give him the opportunity, coach him up, and put it all in his hands. So very, very short and simple and to the point. No, like I said, Nate Sudfeld has been with the Eagles for going to his third year now. I'm hoping that he is not in a situation where he has to come in, knock on wood, and let's pray that he does not have to come in. But Nate Sudfeld, hopefully that, you know, he has learned, you know, he's definitely learned from Nick Foles and Carson Wentz the 3 years he's been here. Obviously, the Eagles have been preparing him to take over that number two spot. Moving on from Nick Foles. Nick Foles, of course, going down to Jacksonville. So the Eagles have been preparing Nate Sudfeld to move into that number two spot for a while. And unless something crazy happens during training camp and preseason, unless something crazy happened like with Clyde or, you know, one of those guys moving up on the depth chart ahead of him, he's going to be the number two guy. He's going to be that guy if, like I said, God forbid something happens to Carson Wentz, he's the guy that's going to fall in his hands and he's going to be the one on the field. I like Nate Sudfeld a lot. I thought it was a great addition to our team when we got him from the Redskins. I thought it was a great addition. But I'll be lying to you if I was to say that I would be very comfortable with him taking over the starting spot. Yeah, he's shown potential during his limited action, you know, his limited playing time. He's shown, you know, flashes of being, you know, some great plays, man. Great potential, man. But if he took over Carson Wentz, I definitely would be concerned. And I'm hoping that Carson Wentz will stay healthy. You know, praying to the football guys that Carson Wentz stays healthy for the duration of his career. I like Nate Sudfeld, but I'm really hoping that we don't get to that situation where Nate Sudfeld, you know, has to come in and, you know, in Carson Wentz's place. But, Doug does believe in him. Obviously, they believe in him. They let Nick Foles move on. Nick Foles went down to Jacksonville to become a starter, obviously. And they, you know, besides drafting the quarterback in the fifth round and bringing in a guy in free agency, you know, they really haven't made too many big, you know, splashy moves. They haven't made any splashy moves at the quarterback position. They obviously believe in Nate Sudfeld. And like I said, hopefully we don't be in that situation where Sudfeld has to come out on the field. But you know, it's just, man. For me, it's just, man. I I just hope we don't be in that situation. That's just my thoughts on it. I like the guy. He has shown some potential when he's played, but it's a big difference going against the third, fourth, fifth string. It's a big difference going against those defenses compared to going against the first and second string defenses in the NFL. But hopefully, like I said, hopefully Nate has learned. He's learned from Carson Wentz. He's learned from Nick Foles. And if that situation does happen, hopefully he goes out there and he keeps the thing going smoothly. Nick Foles obviously kept it going smoothly after Carson went down. So hopefully Nate Sudfeld is ready for that role if it does happen. But like I said, crossing my fingers that it doesn't happen. But Doug Pederson has confidence in him. I love to hear that Doug has confidence in him. But like I said, hopefully we're not in that situation. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Do you think Nate Sudfeld is ready for that number two spot at quarterback? Do you agree with Doug? Do you think that he's ready for it? Would you be comfortable if Nate came in and had to start for whatever reason? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section. As always, go Birds. Spunky Nights 91 is out of here. Fly, Eagle, fly. Peace.